begin with, in Luke chapter 4, verse 24, Jesus handpicked this story. It's a Gentile woman. And this woman is really insignificant in the eyes of everyone. For whatever reason, why is it that this woman was really mentioned by Jesus? If you will read the Talmud records of the rabbis, first thing in the morning, this is how they pray. I thank you, Lord, that I was not born a slave person, that I am not a Gentile or a woman. Alam mo, racism really is coming from different religions. This is what we saw here. And this is a Gentile woman, so much so a widow, which goes to imply to us, even if we are Gentiles, God cares. What seems insignificant to many, whenever it is important to you, it's important to Him because you are important to Him. This woman, a widow from Zarephath, is a Gentile. I assure you that there were many widows in Israel in Elijah's time when the sky was shut for 3.5 years and there was a severe famine throughout the land. I think we have a similar situation today. And I heard some scientists, they believe that up to 2027, this virus is still around. Mas mahirap ngayong 2021 kasi wala nang ayuda. Oh, they allowed people to work. But you see a lot of people, you can feel the hardship. But God will supply our needs according to His riches in glory. Not according to the economy of this world. Not according to your job or your bank account. Not according to anyone. God will supply your needs. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah. So it came to him. Leave here, turn eastward and hide in Kerith Ravine east of the Jordan. You will drink from the brook and I have ordered the ravens to feed you there. Sabi ko nga, raven? No way! Because raven has a bad reputation. Symbolically, you don't receive food from raven. They're scavengers and they feed from dead meat. And yet, God, in a mysterious way, He's using this raven to feed this big name, Prophet Elijah. You know, the message here is sometimes God is using, surprisingly, people that are less superior, so to speak, in their financial status to provide for your needs. Minsan may mga kamag-anak na inaasahan mo na tutulong sa'yo, but they're not there to help you. And how many believe that God, if He wished to, He can provide in thousands of ways? He can use the winds. He can use this pandemic. He can use problems. He can use situations. He can use and command even these ravens. And not just dead meat, but fresh meat, so that Elijah will remain and stay healthy. And this tells us that God can command anything that surrounds us if we manage to believe that He is with us. That the same God of the Jewish people is the same God that Jesus introduced, but better than their revelation, because this God is not only the God of Isaac, Jacob, and Abraham. He is our Heavenly Father. So he did what the Lord had told him. He went to the Kerith Ravine east of Jordan and stayed there. This was mentioned in the Bible, and there is so much story going on. It's so huge that he handpicked this Gentile to represent us as Gentiles. And surprisingly also, what I've learned, Jesus gave commendation of having great faith with only two people in the scriptures. And they are both Gentiles, not Jewish people. And he said, I tell you, I did not see this great faith in the whole entirety of the Jewish community, Israel, but I've seen it only in this centurion. Come on, he's a Gentile, and yet he has this great faith. And today on this side of the cross, he's announcing a prophetic message. All Gentiles today, if they only realize they have great faith. You know why? Because it's not our faith. It's the faith of Christ working in us. The moment you start to unveil the truth, you follow and decipher the truth, you will be amazed what God can do in your life. So the ravens brought him bread and meat in the morning and bread and meat in the evening. Sometime later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. natuyo. Then the word of the Lord came to him, "Go at once to Zarephath of Sidon and stay there. I have commanded a widow in that place to supply with you with food." Where God guides, He provides. Pag mayroon kang nararanasang emptiness or pains, growing pains in a relationship, in your livelihood, in your situation, it means God wants you to move forward. Don't stay in that situation. And don't do the same mistake. Don't do over and over again the same thing and you expect a different result. Growing pains means adjustment. So he went to Zarephath. When he came to the town gate, a widow was there gathering sticks. He called to her and asked, Hey woman, would you bring me a little water in a jar so that I may have a drink?" And she was going to get it. Nung kunin niya, he called, Hey, sandali, pahabol. Please bring me a piece of bread." God, sabi ng Bible, His ways are beyond tracing out. If I were Elijah, I will question the will of God. But it's good that he heard the voice of God. Because from verse 12, look at her response. And you know, it's so humiliating. And God is teaching Elijah this perfect trust to the Lord. Isipin mo, ang magpapakain sa kanya, mas mahirap pa sa daga. There is this contradiction. Because this widow said, "As surely as the Lord, your God lives." She replied, "I don't have any bread." God said, "I will feed you through this widow." And he said, "I don't have any bread. What will you do if you are in that situation? Only a handful of flour in a jar and a little oil in a jug. I am gathering a few sticks to take home and make a meal." Wow, this is so pathetic. This is so miserable, pitiful. This is so discouraging and it's so nakaka-depressing nan, because what she said, ang sakit sa puso. Gutom na nga, agawin mo pa yung tinapay. "And make a meal for myself and my son that we may eat and" what? Meron pa ba mas miserable dito? "We may eat and die." Jesus handpicked this story to represent many Gentiles suffering today. Elijah said to her, "Do not be afraid. Go home and do as you have said. But first, make a small cake of bread for me from what you have and bring it to me. And then make something for yourself and your son. And for this is what the Lord of God of Israel says, the jar of flour will not be used up and the jug of oil will not run dry until the day the Lord gives rain on the land." Until this pandemic ends, it will not run dry. People, God is promising that to anyone who calls on Him, who trusts in Him. If the truth will be revealed, God is using a lot of ways to provide. You know, one thing that surprises me, nagpo-provide ang Lord sa isang widow. Both are in the hands of God, Elijah and this widow. It is God all the way providing. At pag nag-provide ang Lord, hindi tama lang, hindi kulang. He's a God of more than enough, so that you can bless others also. This woman gave all she had. "This is what I have. This is my last meal. We will eat this and we will die." I believe when we are into this frequency of believing that God is our provision, He's our healing, He Himself is our completeness. That's why the Bible says, "Let your conversation be of heaven." It means the way you talk, even the jar is empty, you don't talk as if you are a Gentile, that there is no God. This is not in any way a denial statement. You don't say na wala kang pera kailanman. Kahit walang wala ka na, you don't say that. Speak life to your dead situation. Kahit lahat ng symptoms nasa iyong katawan, nais ng Panginoon, you speak life to your dead situation. Because we are operating under faith. And we have no fear because our vile body will be translated into a glorified body. You see, what I've seen from the Bible is there are a lot of people with the questionable background are drawn to Jesus. No? A woman in the well having previous five affairs. You see that? And she was saved. None of them were judged. Ang babae na kinaladkad sa harapan niya, instead of stoning her to death, he showed mercy. Wow! I don't know what kind of Jesus these folks are sharing. But the Jesus is full of compassion. This Jesus is shouting, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they're doing. This is the kind of Jesus. This is the true Jesus. And Paul said, if you are preaching a different Jesus, you are following a different Jesus, you're preaching a false gospel. There's only one Jesus that Paul says is full of mercy. She went away and did as Elijah told her. So there was food every day for Elijah, for the woman and her family. See that? Sa gitna ng kahirapan, God, this is an amazing story. For the jar of flour was not used up, hindi naubusan, and the jug of oil did not run dry, in keeping with the word of the Lord spoken by Elijah. It reminds us, people, this is the God who dwells in me. He's the one who created the heavens and the earth. I may not understand it. I'll just close my eyes. What will I do if I will be worrying? Jesus said, can it add even a single hour in your life if you worry? No. Just quit worrying and start trusting.